Hello, I'm Dr. Sunita Goyal, high-risk pregnancy specialist and laparoscopic surgeon, Cloudnine Hospital, Ludhiana. So, obstructed labor is a condition in which the fetus head or whatever part is presenting does not come down in the pelvis and delivery does not take place. So there are some causes which can lead to obstructed labor. First thing, in modern obstetrics, there is no patient should go in obstructed labor if she is under the care of a qualified doctor. It occurs only when the patient is neglected in labor. So why it occurs? Whenever there is a problem with the fetus head or the presenting part. So if the head is too big, like when there is fluid in the head, we call this condition as hydrocephalus. Or if baby is very large, like a diabetic baby, more than 4-4.5 kg in weight, then the pelvis may be small for this baby. Or the baby is not presenting by head, malpresentation, like brow presentation or face presentation, in which it is difficult for the fetal head to come out through the pelvis. Obstructed labor can also occur in twins, which are fused together, known as conjoined twins, or interlocking of the twins, where the head of one twin gets locked in the neck of the second twin. It can also occur if there is any tumor in the pelvis, like any fibroid or ovarian mass, or the bony pelvis is small, or there is abnormality in the bony pelvis, then the head can get obstructed. So in this, patient will be having good contractions, good pains, and the delivery does not take place. So most of the time, patient becomes very fatigued, she's very exhausted, restless, dehydrated, she may have low blood pressure, her pulse rate may be high, she may be having fever, she may be having vagina, foul smelling discharge, hot and dry vagina. So these are the symptoms of obstructed labor. It can cause complications in the mother as well as in the baby. In the mother, there can be infections. Immediately after the delivery, there can be severe hemorrhage. If the patient is not taken well care of, she can go into shock. And if the obstructed labor is not relieved, even the uterus can rupture. So mother can die also if the uterus ruptures. When the baby is delivered, baby may be severely asphyxiated. Baby may not cry immediately after birth. Baby can get infections. Baby can have convulsions. Baby may even die. So in modern obstetrics, there should not be any patient going into obstructed labor. We should monitor the progress of the labor well from time to time and see if there is any obstruction to the descent of the presenting part of the fetus and take timely action so that both mother and baby are safe.